This is Michael O'Rourke. I'm the chief engineer for this new vehicle. I'm going to walk you through some of the technical features that I believe take this vehicle to the next level. Now, the base design is really born from a technology that's been proven to be durable and technologically sound. So, for example, we're going to continue to offer the 3.6-liter V6 and the 5.7 V8. But what we're going to do is we're going to marry the 8-speed transmission now with the V8 for the first time. And when we do that, we're going to provide our customers 363 horsepower. But in addition, we're going to provide them a better fuel economy, 1 mile per gallon, both city and combined, in addition to better performance numbers. 0 to 60 drops to 5.8, a 2/10 improvement from today's 5-speed. Suspensions. So in the past, we've offered 2 suspensions, Comfort and Touring. And now we're going to add a 3rd suspension, that being a Sport Tour suspension that will marry with the 300S package that you see here on my right. Electronic power steering. We're going to offer electronic power steering standard on all 300s. Now, what that's going to do for us is really 2 things. It's going to allow us to tune the steering depending on the driving conditions. So in highway conditions, I can stiffen it up. In a parking lot, I can lighten it up. It also allows the driver to choose from 3 different steering tunes. So today, while you're out on your drive, from the radio, you'll be able to choose from 1 of 3 modes: sport, normal, and comfort. And you can do that while you're driving. What I want to do now is move to the safety features. So we've made some significant improvements to several of the safety features on the vehicle. Adaptive cruise control plus stop. So today, when you set your adaptive cruise control on those vehicles so equipped, the cruise control will continue to work up to and including a complete stop. It'll stop for 2 seconds. If the vehicle in front of you continues to proceed, the cruise control system will pick up and continue to work without any driver intervention at all. I find this very helpful in stop and go traffic. You probably see that today. Forward Collision Warning Plus. So what this system will do is alert you both with a visual and an audible alert, but in addition to that, and under certain circumstances, the vehicle will now brake for you without any input. So through our autonomous braking system, again, under certain conditions, under 20 miles per hour, literally the system will prevent you from contacting the car in front of you, again, without any intervention at all.
That's full stop?
Excuse me?
Full stop
at 20 miles an hour.
Is that part of the adaptive system?
Excuse me?
Is that part of the adaptive cruise?
No, it's not. It's not. They do work hand in hand with the radar and the camera.
Question. I know that this isn't Q&A, but my mind is so weak. Can you defeat the adaptive feature in the cruise control? As you can with the Durango, for example?
Yes, you can use the normal. If you want to just use your normal cruise, you can do that. You can use the adaptive separately.
Can you defeat this autonomous braking?
You can. When you go into the, again, if you go into the radio, you'll hit the settings, and you'll come into driver and safety actions, and that'll allow you to make all these, some of these selections.
Is the speed at which the brake would intervene, is that regulated by DOT or NHTSA or somebody? You said it only will and can't stop at 20 miles per hour.
No, what it'll do, maybe to clarify myself, under 20 miles per hour, under normal road conditions, it will bring the vehicle to a stop prior to hitting that vehicle in front of you. It will provide autonomous braking at higher speeds. It will not stop the vehicle. It will just prevent the collision, but the amount of the collision. If that makes sense.
So, but it's the speed. So, will it do that at 80 miles an hour?
There
it
is
a.
Yeah, there's a speed threshold. I'm not sure exactly what it is, but I'll,
I'm just wondering if that's regulated, basically.
I don't know that. I can get back with you. The other safety feature that we've added to the vehicle now is a lane departure and a warning and keep assist. So what this system does is uses the camera at the middle of the windshield. It identifies the lines on a lane, and it will, via a telltale in the cluster, it will let you, the driver, know whether they're coming close to the lane. And in addition, working with the electronic power steering, it will bump the driver back into the lane. So you'll be able to utilize this today during your drive. You'll also be able to go into the 6-inch to the radio, and you can select, number one, how close you want to get to that lane for the system to come and alert you. You can also select the amount of steering that you want to drive you back into the lane. Okay, there's a few other features that have been mentioned earlier that I want to just hit one more time before you head out on your drive, because I think they really improve the driver interface with the vehicle. First of all, Chris went through that cluster, that big 7-inch cluster, right in your face, easy to see, configurable. That's number one. Number two, the steering wheel, the controls. Very easy to use. Very easy to see. The Uconnect system. So the Uconnect system, we've added several apps to the system, two of which I'll note here, the Wi-Fi hotspot and Uconnect access, which allows a driver to start their car via their mobile phone from a distance. The rotary shifter. So the rotary shifter, I think you'll find it today very easy to use, very intuitive, well packaged right in the middle of the console. And last but not least, at the back of the console, we've added two USB charging ports for my kids who happen to ride in the back of the seat. So with that, I'll turn it over to Andy for one brain. Thank you.